Okay, cool. So let me move you guys around.
We are here in LA for the Grammy announcement nominations concert. I'm so excited about it. It's the first time ever we're doing this. It's gonna be really, really fun. Some of my favorite artists are here, and I'm so excited because I get to co-host. I try not to get attached to it, to thinking that I would be nominated for something, but you know, it would be wonderful if I was. It would be so incredible. You never get your hopes up or anything like that, but the Grammys are the biggest thing. The Grammys are what you want. They're what you hope for. They're what you dream about when you're a little kid, if you want to do music. So they're sort of on this pedestal, and just to be involved in any part with this is just incredible.
Here we go. For Best New Artist, the nominees are Taylor Swift.
I can't believe I'm nominated for a Grammy. I can't believe that happened.
Your first Grammy Awards, right?
Yeah, I've never been before.
So. It's very exciting.
Yes!
Yeah, and you seem calm for such a big show.
I'm not really that calm. This is my first Grammys I've ever been to, and I'm already so overwhelmed. There are so many famous people here. You know what? I'm not going to prom this year. I decided to go to the Grammys instead, so.
Not a bad trade-off.
Not a bad trade-off.
I'd go for that.
And I don't want anyone feeling bad for me, because I've already been to prom twice. So I got to go my freshman and my sophomore year, and I'm just happy going to the Grammys.
Right, so these years, the nominees for Best New Artist are Taylor Swift. Oh my gosh. And the winner is... Yes! Yes! Amy Winehouse!
And the Grammy goes to... Rihanna featuring Jay-Z for Umbrella! Thank you.
Performing together for the first time, Taylor Swift and Miley Cyrus.
Grammy Day, I just saw the best thing I've ever seen in my life. Behold,
it's Katy Perry's dress. And behind it is Katy Perry.
And I don't have any makeup on.
Okay, this is rehearsal day, camera blocking for the Grammy. I just played on the Grammys for the first time in my whole life, and it was so much fun. Thank you so much for tagging along.
Let's do the count. I think you have 45 Grammy nominations, right?
No, it's more like 65 million.
65? Jeez, I mean, are you used to this kind of... I mean, you've won every award, and...
I can't even believe what's happened in the past couple of months. You know, it just... Yeah. The Grammy nominations were... Getting that phone call... And seeing that on TV when they announced that, it was one of those things that I'm never going to forget, that moment. And, you know, I wrote it in my diary that night in, like, giant marker, like, I can't believe this. And it's just been amazing. So thank you for everything.
What's the, I feel like you've won so many things this year. There's things that obviously you're nominated for that you could win. Is there one that's going to make you, like, the most proud? Is there one thing you're going to be like, oh, okay, can't believe I won that?
Well... I think it would be, you know, any kind of Grammy, because I've never won a Grammy before.
Sure.
And then under that would be subtext one would be would be album of the year. I think would just be. I can't believe I'm nominated in a category like that. It's just to be nominated in all the major categories of the Grammys is just blowing my mind. Wonderful to be at the Grammys. I've never won a Grammy before, so.
Well, you're up for some major awards this year. How do you feel about it? A little nervous, or?
I feel awesome about having, I feel like it's wonderful to have 8 chances to win one. You know, and I'll forever be thankful that, you know, my album was nominated for Album of the Year. That's something that I'll always remember and always be appreciative of. I don't know who's going to win, and I have no idea what it's like to walk up there and accept a Grammy, but I imagine it would be unforgettable.
It is the day of the Grammy.
So why can't you see?
Swift.
This is my first Grammy, you guys. I mean, this is a Grammy. You know, Liz Rose and I co-wrote this song together, and she started writing songs with me when we just won a Grammy.
I just won my first two Grammy Awards in my whole life. I'm still freaking out. It was at the pre-telecast, and we are transporting to the red carpet. This takes a lot of effort to walk in. See? You have to walk really slowly like this.
Grammy goes to Taylor Swift.
This is my first time walking up those stairs to accept a Grammy on national television. Thank you so much.
This is Grammy backstage. I've won three Grammys. And I'm so excited, I'm freaking out. There's a jam session that has broken out.
Taylor Swift, Nathan Chapman and Taylor Swift.
Featured artist, Colby Calais.
This is the coolest night ever, and I'm never gonna forget it in my life. There's been so much crying and hyperventilating, and I'm just like, God, I love you, Grammys.
I wonder what it would be like to win a Grammy someday. I never actually could fathom that it might happen until I was walking up there and winning one. I'm gonna celebrate for the rest of my life. Thank you so much, you guys.
Congratulations on the Grammys.
Thank you.
So well deserved again. So well deserved. Third awards.
Yeah, I couldn't believe it. At no point in my life did I ever think there would be a morning where I got to wake up and think, I won four Grammys last night. It was such a wonderful experience, and I honestly never expected that would happen.
It's just amazing. Congratulations.
Thank
but it's well
you.
Deserved.
I'm so excited about this year's Grammys. I mean, the awards, the once-in-a-lifetime performances.
The host.
There's a host?
I'm the host.
Awkward. I don't know. I didn't know. It's nice to see you always. Very impressive.
Oh, thank you. Not too bad yourself.
Yeah, I was talking about the giant Grammy.
Oh.
Yeah.
My bad. Get that spot right there. Taylor, right here. Get that spot. Give me the rag.
Fine.
Yeah, fine. Tune in February 12th to see who cleans up at the Grammys.
Taylor Swift performs and LL hosts the Grammys.
It may not be Taylor Swift.
Come on! Grammy week is really unlike anything else. It is full of excitement and anticipation and nerves and anxiety and, you know, ultimately the most exciting night in music. I mean, it just... For me to get to be a part of it for a few years now is such a treat, and I feel so lucky to get to be here and take part in all of this, because it's like, it's the most amazing circus you could ever see and be a part of. Being nominated for three awards this year is so wonderful. I'm nominated twice for the song Mean and once for my album for Speak Now, and it means a lot to me because I wrote this album by myself without any co-writers, so for it to be honored by the Grammys is... It's just such an amazing feeling. It's been a really overwhelming life so far for me, and I'm just really thankful that the Grammys have been such a big part of that.
But someday I'll be singing this at the Grammys, and all you're ever gonna be is me.
And the Grammy goes to
Mean Taylor Swift. Oh, wow. Oh, hi. This is fantastic. You know, it's always going to mean the world to me, you know, the idea of getting to go to the Grammys and the idea of getting to possibly have a chance at winning a Grammy, but this one really means a lot to me because this is for a song called Mean that I wrote. And there's
There's really no feeling quite like writing a song about someone who's really mean to you and someone who completely hates you and makes your life miserable and then winning a Grammy for it. Wow. Taylor Swift for Mean. Wow. Thank you to anyone who voted for this song. That is so incredible of you for doing that. Wow. This is another Grammy. This is unbelievable. I am so happy right now. Thank you to all the Grammy voters. Everyone who clapped when I won this, thank you so much.
This is so amazing to have won two Grammys already before the televised portion even starts. This is unbelievable. I won two Grammys for this song that I wrote called Mean that really meant a lot to me, and it means so much to me that the Grammy voters decided to vote that way, and I'm just having such a wonderful time.
Now. Her proudest moment of 2012?
I think it was the Grammys. We were performing on the Grammys and we got a standing ovation for the performance.
It was 2 years earlier, Swift was panned by critics for an off-key Grammy performance with Stevie Nicks. Flash forward to this year, a rousing set left Taylor feeling vindicated.
Such an unbelievable feeling to get that kind of, like, I guess, like, tip of the hat from everybody in the music industry that I respect.
Grammys is a different, entirely different thing than anything else, award show-wise. Any music award show, any kind of event that you'll ever do, the Grammys stands on its own. It's the biggest deal of anything music has to offer. It's so exciting to get to be included year after year, and especially to be able to put forth a different kind of performance every single time. I'm really excited about the Grammys because we're opening the show, and so what that essentially means is you get to perform and then you get to watch the show stress-free. You get to just go out there and watch and see what happens and watch the whole night unveil. I've never really experienced it like that before. You're always like waiting, you're like nervous about your performance, and you're nervous about everything, and I'm probably still gonna be nervous about everything, but less so, because my performance is the first thing.
So he calls me up and he's like, I still love you, and I'm like, I'm sorry, I'm busy opening up the Grammys, and we're never getting back together, like ever.
Okay, you know what, this is unbelievable. You guys are amazing, we just won a Grammy for that. Yes!
Just won a Grammy for the song that we wrote for the Hunger Games soundtrack.
I did not think that was going to happen.
You know what, but thanks to the fans, thanks to the Grammy voters, it did. We're so stoked.
Essentially, I feel like all the hard work and effort and amazingness that you guys have put into this last year. Did anyone here buy my album Red? Okay, so you did. So this is for you, this message, this anecdote. You guys and all your hard work and your dedication all added up, and everything that happened in the last year added up. And we got the news today that Red got nominated for Album of the Year at the Grammys. And to say that I'm excited about it would be such an understatement. To say that I ran around screaming for a few hours about it. I'm so happy. This is the best birthday week possible.
Congratulations on everything. I mean, I would say this is your year, but I think every year for the past few years has been your year. What does it feel like to have so many nominations over and over again?
It's wonderful. Tonight, I think being nominated for Album of the Year is the biggest, most incredible honor. I mean, the fact that they pick 5 albums out of the entire year and you get to be one, it's just amazing. And
so a party after the Grammys for Taylor Swift.
Well, I hope so. I mean, hopefully.
Oh, I think you're going to have a lot to party about for sure. There's no question about that.
I think if the performance goes well, if my friends win anything, that will be reason to party.
First, she's going to take a moment to send her millions of followers around the world a tweet. Stay tuned, because she, the amazing and beautiful and lovely, most lovely girl, Taylor Swift, is about to take this stage.
Taylor. Music gave her the perfect way to express whatever she was going through. A little high five.
Random access memories, death.
I got nominated for Album of the Year with Red. Going up to it, you know, everybody comes up to you and they're like, oh, you got this, you're gonna win. And I wish they wouldn't do that, because you don't know if you're gonna win. And someone else could very well win, and someone else very well did. When they announced the Album of the Year winner, it was like, and the Album of the Year goes to Random Access Memories, Daft Punk, and they really dragged out the rap. And I was like, for a second there, I kind of thought we had it, and we didn't. I remember not going to after parties. I went home and I cried a little bit, and I got in an Out Burger and ate a lot.
Why did you name the album 1989?
That's a good question. I named it 1989 because when was it? It was Grammy night this year that I decided that was the title. I remember it really vividly. I came home from the Grammys and I was sitting on the couch eating In-N-Out Burger.
So Taylor, 3 Grammy nominations. Where were you when you found out? How did you respond? How did you react?
I was about to get on a plane to go to LA to play Jingle Ball there. And I found out because I think Lord texted me. I find out everything from her.
Right.
That was when I found out about just one of them. And then throughout the day, they announced more. And by the time I landed in LA, we found out it was 3. And Record of the Year and Song of the Year were 2 of them.
So you had a little smile on your face.
Oh, I was so excited. But I had laryngitis, so I couldn't talk about it.
Right.
With my voice.
I just wanted to show the legs, because as I was telling you ahead of time, you're going to walk home with more than maybe just a trophy tonight. I think lots of men.
I'm not going to walk home with any men tonight. I'm gonna go hang out with my friends, and then I go home to the cats.
I love this dress. Can we talk about it? Who made this dress?
This is Ellie Saab.
Okay.
And I picked it because it's, well, honestly, because it's going to be good for dancing.
Yeah, right?
So I'm really excited. And the Grammy goes to Sam Smith.
That
that still happens? You'll get nominated for Grammys and your friends are like, oh my gosh,
my
got
friends
nominated.
Freak out over it.
That's really cool.
It's such a big deal to get nominated for Record of the Year and Song of the Year. And
no, the one that you're really excited.
Solo pop performance.
Yeah. Best pop performance. That's the one.
It's really exciting because like this was the first time I've made a pop album. So to be nominated in the only pop category I was eligible for.
Yeah.
Was really cool. And the Record of the Year one is sick too.
I would imagine so.
I love it.
Can we?
So what's keeping you busy these days?
I'm just working out and getting ready for Grammys.
What's the most exciting thing in life right now?
Grammys.
What's one accomplishment you're most proud of?
My Grammys.
Grammy goes to Bad Blood, Taylor Swift featuring Kendrick Lamar.
Hold on, I want to call Taylor. Oh, I don't have her number. Shit. She'll find out.
She's gonna freak, hold on.
Hello?
Taylor, it's Jack. I'm not doing a bit, we just won Pop Vocal Album. Can you hear?
Nathan Chapman, Imogen Heap, Max Martin, Matt Mann and Robin, Ali Fayami, Shellback, Taylor Swift, Ryan Tedder, and Noel Zach.
I want to thank the fans for the last 10 years.
I had one Album of the Year at the Grammys for a second time, which I never thought was a possibility. And I remembered thinking afterward, oh my God, that was all you wanted.
This is the story we're gonna be telling over and over again. In 2010, how we got to win Album of the Year at the Grammys. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Oh God, that was all you wanted. That was all you focused on.
Thank you for this moment.
You just made me do. Look what you just made me. Ooh, look what you made me do.
The big categories of album, record, song, you are not nominated.
You know what? Like, this is fine. This is, yeah. I just need to make a better record.
Well, Reputation is a great record.
No, I'm making a better record.
So great to see you. Congratulations on all those nominations. So how does it feel to be closing in on Stevie Wonder and Frank Sinatra for the most wins on Album of the Year?
Yeah, the Grammy news was absolutely unbelievable. And in terms of those unbelievable records
I try not to jinx things, to quote Michael Scott from The Office. I'm not superstitious, but I am a little stitious.
How crazy is it that you are re-recording all of your songs on the 13th anniversary of your first ever Grammy nomination? I know 13 is your favorite number, so what would you tell that girl during her first Grammy nomination about the next 13 years of her career?
Hi, Kelty. So your question is a great one. It is pretty wild how much time has passed since my first Grammy nomination, and I still feel really lucky to have a chance to be a part of this night. I think the advice I would give myself when I was younger is probably to, when things get hard, always focus in on how much I love music. So one thing I can tell you about my Grammy performance that isn't highly confidential is that my Grammy performance includes my collaborators Aaron Dessner and Jack Antonoff, which is really exciting because this has been an adventure that the three of us have gone on since the very beginning of quarantine and lockdown. And, you know, we've only gotten to be together in the same room once. And so this is really awesome to get to be together with them again. We're quarantining in the same house for the whole week. We're tested every day. So it's just really exciting, honestly, to play music with your collaborators. That's something that I will never, ever take for granted again.
Daughters and my son, y'all are all watching Blue.
Mostly, we just want to thank the fans. You guys met us in this imaginary world that we created, and we can't tell you how honored we are forever by this. Thank you so much, and thank you to the Recording Academy. We'll never forget that you did this for us. Thank you so much.
Subscribe to this channel.